Good morning, class. We are going to end of this today's lesson, the lesson about the field establishment of the British rule in India. So, in the last two previous classes, we were discussing like how the Britishers came to the overthrow of the Indian Empire into the Indian soil. So, in detail we have been discussed. So, I'll just give a glance once again, like what way we have been discussed from the last class. The very first we have been get to know like how they have been came for the trading purpose for the small empire. They came very first one for the establishment of the East India Company. For that purpose they have been came. For what means trading in what aspect? For cloth, especially in the cotton and silk. Then at the same time they also started doing the trade in the spices like cardamom, the next cloves, spices all which in our country it is being grown up. So they wanted to have the do the trade with the people who have been growing this kind of cloth and this kind of spices, purchasing at very cheap prices and selling out in their continent, in the Europe continent place at very high prices. So basically, the first Britishers they have been came. So slowly, one after the other company, other countries people they also started coming, like Dutch people, Portuguese, then next Holland, all these Spain. All these people have started coming to India by finding the sea routes through the waterways. So like Vasco da Gama, the next Columbus, all they have been finding out the sea routes to India with the water, through the water mode, and they have also started doing the trade. So trade has become like a competition between Britishers, between the France, between Holland, all these people. So they started protecting their places where they have been protecting in a such a way that even sometimes they have the clashes between the one company people and to the other company people who are being trading. So in this way they started protecting their traders with the help of weapons, armed traders. So in this protecting armed traders, they had a conflict war between the British army, East India Company, and the French East India Company. So basically Europe continent has been under the rule of the monarchy, queen is been doing, Queen Elizabeth I. So they had a war between, fight between the French East India Company and the East India Company. So all their kings, they are supporting them that by sending out the armies, by sending out the weapons, by sending out the money which they require to protect and to get the victory. Why they have been in such a way? Because whoever got get the victory, they can have the complete control over the Indian soil. So ultimately the British has been won. So that was armed traders. And next they have started using the misuse of the company's name or power. Like they were from the local traders, local kings, they were doing the trading, purchasing all the spices and cloth. Instead of selling it to their East India Company, they were selling directly to their nation. So in the name of company, they have been doing like a corruption type. So they were getting the money profit in it need to get to the company, but instead of getting it to the company, they are taking the, that amount for themselves. This was all. Then second, what was the synopsis which we have been discussed? The other one was growing European interference in the Kingdom of India. So slowly what the British they started doing, they started interfering in the Indian Kingdom, Indian laws, whichever the places like Deccan, Maharashtra, Bengal, all these places, still the Nawabs, Subedars, Rajas, they were ruling out kingdoms. So in the kingdom they have made said that one person in their kingdom, in the Indian kingdom, one person will be get resided, will exist. So that person known as resident. So what this resident person will be doing, he will be have a complete looking over the kingdom, how the kings have been working, how much of wealth they are having, to which they are being. So in complete detailed information, he will pass it to the company, the owner of this Indian company or to the officer. So what will he be doing? So whenever there is a fight between one kingdom to the other kingdom, they see that which kingdom is having more of money, more of wealth, so that they can use. So likewise, they are supporting the king who is having more of wealth, more of power. So in return, because they have been helping with their army, because their army is very powerful, having much of weapons, much of cannons, so in return they want to get the money or the place. So likewise, they have been given the example of Dupleix, the governor of the Nizam Muzaffar's state of Deccan part. So this Muzaffar Jung has been supported by the French French officer. So in Britain, they are been giving to whom they have been supporting. Like Jagir is money for any kind of jewelry. That makes some amount to the company they have been supported, like the East India Company or the French East India Company, whichever the company they have been supporting to them money. First is to the Governor General, the army officer money, then next to Jagir, then next to the company, and at the same time one place or an area to as a form of gift. Then next every year some amount they need to pay as a form of the gift type, every per annum they need to pay. So likewise many they have been using this kind of app, so the many things they are supporting, in return they have been getting these things. So these things are the, like amount, money, jewelry, the places, the areas. So that areas they will using as a military base. Military base means they have been using that place for their military, for their soldiers to reside to, and with that money whatever they are being given by the Indian kings, they were using that money for purchasing of the weapons, for the guns, cannons, all they have been using, and they with that they have been making their army very powerful. And at the same time, our Indian kingdom, our Indian the kings and the rulers who were ruling, they have been getting up. Like how the British, they started playing the role with the Indian Indian rulers. So they got to know the giving of money, the giving of gifts, the giving of the places, it became very dangerous. Because when, by giving all this, they were allowing themselves to get rule the places, which were the things they have been giving up. So in this way, they stopped giving, and the British also, they doesn't want to be get these things stopped by the Mughal rulers. So slowly one after the other, they started ruling to their places, like whichever the colony, whichever the place these rule, the Indian rulers have been given, that place that area became a colony for the British. They started ruling. Whoever be the king, you need to be the king, but you need to follow our rules and regulations, our orders, all the natural resources they will start using. So ultimately what happens here is, not only the very first the battle which happened is, it was in the year 1757, Battle of Plassey. This 1757 Battle of Plassey was being headed by Sirajul Daulah, Nawab of Bengal, East part of India, West Bengal, East Bengal places. So that place, it was being a Battle of Plassey in the year 1757. Sirajul Daulah has defeated the only one that defeat, and that was the first case that Indian soil had that was being ruled by the British. 1757 Battle of Plassey. So slowly one after the other kingdom, other places it was being ruled by the British. So Battle of Plassey, the very first battle. Then the second is for the Deccan part of India. Deccan means Hyderabad province. Hyderabad was the province state. So this was being completed to the coastal plains. At that time Andhra Pradesh, Telangana was not existing. Only the Deccan part was the existing. So they were asking the coastal part of India. Vishakhapatnam, East Godavari, the next to West Godavari, Natasha, all these places they wanted. We wanted to look because coastal areas. Coastal areas because of the water, their bodies, easy transportation. So likewise they have been good. And in return for this, the British, they are going to have an army for the Nizams. Instead of helping the army to the Nizams, they started controlling to the Nizam rulers only. This is the second. Then next other places like Tipu Sultan, Hyder Ali of Mysore, then Shinde of Maharashtra, all these people, they started waging the war against the British. They started fighting towards the British. But these people, they were small in numbers, small kingdoms. So easily everyone got defeated. So by the way, slowly all the places from north part, the east part, the west part, already the center part, all the small areas, small kingdoms are occupied by the British. And who are the most important general officers of the British are three officers. The first is General Robert Clive, second is Warren Hastings, and the last third is Lord Wessex. So these three are the major general officers who played an important role to get rule into the Indian soil. Next area is about how they were not happy with the British rule as they started imposing. So in that, there were five Indian people, they are giving their opinion like why they were not happy. First thing, whenever the king, the place it is being they are being giving about the farmers and traders of making a lot of interest, say, charging very whatever the products they have been producing, they were making means purchasing it very cheap and selling out at high prices. This is the problem with the farmers and traders. Next thing, third one is about the tribal people. The tribal people in the forest areas, they were meaning mostly the tribal people in they used to live in the forest and the place. So the land, the trees, they were using for the tree branches, they were used for the making the railway tracks, then all the places they were doing the deforestation. So they had a fight between the tribal people with the English officers. So this was the problem of the tribal people. Then next about the religion. So the religion in what sense? Like if you were British European people belongs to the Christianity religion. So they will fear that they might ask the our religion people to transfer adopt their religion and go with the English education and try to have manipulate the people of both the religion. So these were the four aspects where the British's rule was being not the Indian people were not happy with the rule of importing British's religion. So slowly after these all the by seeing all the problems after from 1757 to till by the year 1857, before 1857 already the British's army became very powerful, and in the British's army they have been before this one they get to know that with the help of army they can defeat the Indian any Indian soldier because of the power of army they have been getting, and the Indian soldiers they were lacking behind. They were not good with the as compared to the British. Why they were lacking behind is they were not getting the proper salaries. They were not that much of fit and good like how the British. No parade, no exercise, and at the same time the Indian army not having that much of guns, cannons. How much the British? They were well the equipment, not the equipment. So in this way the Indian army was being lagging. So some of the Indian army officers, people, they joined the British. Like equipment. So when they joined in the British army, again the problem arises. What kind of problem? The very first problem was the British army people and the Indian army people, they were not treated equally. Second one, their salaries also get deferred. And third one, they have been felt that the religious feelings were violated. So what the religious feeling they violated? Because the guns, what they were using, to see that one in the yesterday's class I have been listening. So to see the gun, they have been using the animal fat. Because Islam religion, they hate the pig animal. That fat they are using for the Muslims in the Indian army to the Indian soldiers. And whereas for the Hinduism, they worship the cow as a religious animal type. So that cow of fat they were using for the Hindu soldiers. So they have been feeling that their religious rites have been used and they are playing with the religious aspects. So this was being started happening between the 1857 March. So in the Gopalpur place, Kolkata. So they have been went and saw whether it is true or any kind of false or which is happening. So when they went and saw, it was preparing with the fat, animal fat. They were putting with this animal fat, the guns. So immediately by the 10th May 1857, the Battle of Revolt of 1857 was being started. So it was being started from Central India, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Meerut place, 10th May 1857, and they have been early morning, early midnight time started. So the Indian soldiers revolted against the British. British soldiers revolted against them. They opened the fire and they started killing the British officers. So slowly, slowly from the Meerut place, they moved towards the Delhi, passing the Yamuna River. And whichever, whatever the British officers, British police station, whatever been coming, they were setting out on fire, the railway station, telegram booths, all it was being happened in the man. So by one next day morning, early morning, they have been reached to Delhi, and in Delhi they have been Bahadur Shah Zafar, the Mughal Emperor Mughal, the British has made him imprisonment because they wanted to know the Delhi place of this. So they made this Bahadur Shah Zafar, the Mughal Emperor, and these people they have been rewarded, like we want the Mughals back for the British. So it was a wide span, not only in Delhi and Meerut, but all the places, all the countries of India, every people, irrespective of their religion differences, irrespective of the caste difference, irrespective of the state difference, everyone has been started helping on the people, even the money lenders, even the zamindars. Not only that, even the kings, the king rulers also supported the this kind of reform. It was so widespread from every village to every town. It was being given. So at that time, our army was nearly 2 lakhs and 3,000 Indian soldiers. Compared to the British, it was only 45,000. So the British also, they will get back to protect their families. Now they did not support the British. So it was nearly 1 year to suppress this revolt. So all these people who have been supported, like Nana Sahib, the next Ramesthan of our Hyderabad, the next Mami Alauddin, and at the same time, there were also other Rani Lakshmi Bai, all these rulers who have been supported to the revolt. And it has been so widespread that whichever the places they have been coming, they were uprooting, and completely they were destroying, they were burning the railway tracks, police stations, the British's bungalow places, all they have been started doing. So how now the British, they were like completely shaken up, how to control this revolt. So nearly it took them 1 year for them to control this 1857 revolt, and this has given the British that when the Indian people, irrespective of any differences, if they join, they can achieve anything, irrespective of British's having so much of army power. So let's see how they have been to control this revolt, and what in turn they treated the Indians, and after the revolt, how was the situation, and how Hyderabad came into it, merged into the Indian country as not of state. Despite the widespread success of the revolt, the English slowly gained control over the situation. The rebels fought bravely, but there were two major weaknesses among them. In every town and region, different groups of rebels fought separately against English. They did not fight together. There were no combined and well-planned efforts. So the English were able to tackle the rebels one by one in each area. The rebels also faced a shortage of modern arms. The guns and the cannons, cartridges and gunpowder they used were brought from outside India. Consequently, the rebels had to fight with old guns, arrows, spears and swords. Even then, the speed of which the British threatened the English, they behaved greater cruelty when they suppressed a rebel group. They killed the rebels in most inhuman ways and hanged their bodies from trees in the village so that village folk would understand the consequence of the revolt. They tied some rebels to the mouths of the cannons and blew them to it. Many rebels went into hiding, moving from place to avoid being caught by the English. Many of them even went to places like Nepal to hide. The English deported Emperor Bahadur Shah Zafar to a far away location in Rangoon. It was there the last Mughal emperor died. The revolt of 1857 was the biggest revolt to challenge the might of the English. After suppressing it, their hold over India became stronger and they ruled the country for the next 9 years. So what are the consequences? How they have been suppressed is two weaknesses they have been get to know about the Indian soldiers. Means these rebel people who have been started revolting against the British. The very first, they were very lacking in the weapons. They were not having the cartridges. They were using the swords. They were using the bows and arrows. And for the guns, for the cartridges, they were getting from the, they were importing, means purchasing from the other countries, not of India. First one. Second, one group fighting separately, other group fighting separately, others separately. So in this way, they started fighting separately. So while they have been tackled slowly in the manner, like one tackle, second tackle, in this way. And inhuman type of treatment they started. Inhuman type of treatment, whenever any rebel group they caught, they were hanging it to in front of all the people, or they were in their mouth, they were keeping the guns and cartridges, they were blowing up. Inhuman type of cruelty they have been they started doing, and in the consequently they have been started to control the place, and to not to caught by the British, some people has left the country, went to the other neighboring places. So after suppressing of this revolt, they have been continued to rule in the Indian soil for the 90 years. And next time, in this the last Mughal emperor, Bahadur Shah Zafar, who was in Delhi, they transported it from that place to the present in Bangladesh, where he has been died. So in the